Well, hello, everybody. This is Chris Allen coming to you from Bowling Green, Kentucky. Now, normally, I'm all about the weather. In fact, I have another podcast here on Spreaker that's called the Chris Allen Weather Podcast. And because I'm in Southern Kentucky, I focus the forecast on Southern Kentucky. And it's a podcast I've had going for many, many years. But my other passion besides weather is music. And really good music. And I'm talking the classics. Whether it be classic country, classic rock, it doesn't matter. That's what I grew up in. I grew up in Nashville. So everything that you're going to hear me talk about has to do with Nashville or the music centers of the world besides Nashville. And that would be places like Memphis, of course, and Muscle Shoals, of course. New York City, Hollywood, if I have to throw them in there, okay. But really, I'm talking about the South. I'm talking about where music was born. Even here in Kentucky is considered one of the music capitals of the world. So we call this the Little Friday Show. And the reason we do that is because, well, on Thursdays on my TV show, which is called AM Kentucky, which is broadcast on WBKO Channel 13, the ABC affiliate here in Bowling Green, Kentucky. It's been a standing tradition that we call Thursdays Little Friday. It's because it's the day before Friday. So people get confused with that, but then when I stop doing it, people ask that I keep doing it. So therefore, I thought, well, I need to come up with a good name for this show. And so I thought, well, why not do it on Thursdays and call it the Little Friday Show? And that way it's not in the context of, well, it's going to be a country music show, or it's going to be a rock show, or it's going to be this kind of whatever genre of music. I get to choose. And then I'll just make it whatever I want. So it's just going to be about good music. And I'm going to tell you maybe something behind the song that I know that is significant or got me hooked on the song, and a little bit of history that I know behind the song. I have in front of me a Billboard book of top 40 songs, country, rock, pop, it doesn't matter. I've got a whole room full of CDs and vinyl and even 8-track tapes and cassettes. I mean, I'm an audiophile. I collect music, and I listen to music on a regular basis. I can't do without it. So this is just a show that shares some of the good music that I like to listen to. And you can choose to listen to this or not, but you're not going to hear me just play songs over and over again. I'm going to select some songs that I feel like are just really, really cool songs, and I'll tell you why I think they're cool. How's that? We'll just make it that informal, because I thought about putting together a really slick show, and I thought, slick is not me. I mean, I want it to sound professional, but I don't want it to be so tightly produced that it sounds like it came out of Hollywood or New York City. I want it to be loose and fancy free. So I thought this song that I'm about to play really sets the tone for what the Little Friday Show is all about. This song is by a performer who, when he was in his heyday, was just at the top of his craft. And he came away with a number of top 10 hits. He also came away with kind of his own TV show for a while. In fact, he had a TV series from 1974 to 1976. Born in Lubbock, Texas. Yeah, and he even has a song about that. In 1942. He worked as a regional rep for VJ and Liberty Records back before Liberty was a part of EMI Records. And this is another thing. I pay attention to record labels, like who the producer is, who the writers are, when it was done, when it charted, Who are some of the pickers on the performance and that sort of thing. He was in several movies because of his good looks, and this song is one of my favorites because this is a guy who loved Elvis. He loved the Memphis sound, and he also loved the Muscle Shoals sound. Muscle Shoals, Alabama, Fame Recording, Muscle Shoals Sound Studios, all of that. In fact, he wrote one of his greatest songs on the staircase at Fame Recording Studios, which I've been to several times there in Muscle Shoals, Alabama. Rick Hall and the great folks down there. In fact, the very first chart song he had was called Baby Don't Get Hooked on Me, because Rick Hall had told him you didn't write a song that had a good enough hook to it. So Mac got mad and decided, I'm going to write a song with a hook in it, and he wrote Baby Don't Get Hooked on Me. But that's not the song I'm going to play. The song I'm going to play also has hooked in it. He was hooked on music.
It was New Year's Eve. I was 14 at the time. I was celebrating 4 a.m. with them hoodlum friends of mine. I heard a boy named Elvis Presley singing, that's all right, Mama, on the radio. And it turned me on. Moment on. Yeah. Well, all my friends thought I had one brick less than a load. Cause I'd stop the car and I'd jump out and start dancing in the road. When I heard Jerry Lee Lewis singing, oh, I'm shaking, going on. It turned me on. I've been hooked on music, hooked on music from that moment on. Stealing fancy hubcaps on them cowboys' pickup trucks. Fender skirts and mud flaps, anything to make a buck. I'd sell them right back to them out behind the rodeo, just to make a little money to trade my little honey to a rock and roll show. And I hung around that skating rink where Buddy Holly played. I could not believe one man could have such fun and still get paid. When I heard
Davis, Hooked on Music. That is one of the cooler tracks that Mac ever put together. And I really like that one because it's it just has that feel to, you know, the Carl Perkins kind of a guitar and a little bit of Elvis thrown in there. I mean, the Elvis sound. And Mac Davis, you know, is his way of, he did a lot of songs about music. And it was just, yeah, I think his appreciation for music is a lot like mine. You just listen to a little bit of everything, soak it all in like a sponge, and then you just listen to it for hours and hours and hours. And, you know, it's what keeps me going. It's what really just keeps me kind of pumping along. Even on a bad day, I can just listen to a good song like that, and I'm good. I can be down and just listen to something like, you know, Hooked on Music or any number of songs. If they've got the right feel, the right, you know, the right tempo, the right just feeling for the moment, it just makes all the difference in the world. And that's what this show is, the Little Friday Show, just a celebration of good music, no matter what kind of music it is. Another favorite of mine is a guy who, from Florida, he started out as a teenager as a rock and roller. He listened to a lot of Jimi Hendrix, Rolling Stones. He was really into all that. But when he first heard George Jones, Merle Haggard, some of the classics of country music, he decided, well, that's what I'm going to pick up my guitar, go to Nashville. And when he got here in about 71, he showed up at his sister's house and took on odd jobs during the day. And one of those was he picked up a hammer and a box of nails and started roofing at what was then the brand new Grand Ole Opry House at Opryland. Remember Opryland, USA? I do. I used to go there all the time and ride the Wabash Cannonball. And then, of course, the Ryman was the home of the Opry for so long, but it was in the early 70s. When they built Opryland USA out on Brawley Parkway and decided that they were going to move the Grand Ole Opry to the brand new Grand Ole Opry House from the Ryman. Well, this guy was one of the people that helped build the roof. He was one of those people way up there. And little did he know, only a few years later, that he would become one of the people that would be inside the Grand Ole Opry House as one of the performers. And this guy's one of his first hit singles is one of my favorite songs of all time. Here is the great John Anderson with a great song that is just one of, as I've told you, that's one of my favorite songs. And it's not wanting to play. Why is it not wanting to play? See, this is why this episode of the Little Friday Show is the experimental episode, because I could work out all the kinks. Here he is, John Anderson, 1959, on the Little Friday Show.
Cigarettes were a quarter then. Bobby socks and jeans were in. Elvis sang songs that we loved so. And the most important thing to us was keeping gas in my old truck so I could take us to the drive-in show. Then graduation finally came. Uncle Sam called me away. You married someone else while I was gone. But I've kept your letter all these years, and I can't help but shed a tear when I read the words you wrote me years ago. Baby, I'm yours. I love you always. I'm gonna stand. Together, signed, Love Betty, 1959. I never will forget the day when you and I went all the way. I was the first for you, and you for me. I've still got the truck that we loved in. It takes me back there now and then, back to 59 in my memory. And baby, I